back to the second part of the session. So in our previous session, we have dealt that there are some particular activities for which the stimulus is required and immediate response is being given. There are two types of involuntary functions, that's what we have discussed. One type of involuntary functions does not require any particular stimulus for them, and for that we have given the heartbeat as one of the examples. And there are one more type of involuntary functions for which the stimulus is required. For that actually we have tried to know that they can be turned as the reflex actions. So we have also discussed that the afferent nerves are the ones which will try to conduct the stimulus inside the body of the organism, and that particular stimulus have to be sent to the brain, and the brain will be giving the exact response that the organism should be giving in respect with that particular stimulus. So under the involuntary functions, we have told about reflex actions. What exactly are reflex actions? I have told that, for example, the general pathway of any particular nerve reaction is nothing but from the sense organs to the brain and from the brain into the sense organs. So immediately after the stimulus is being sensed by the nerves or the neurons of the nerves, they will be actually transferring that particular message to the brain, and after they receive that particular stimulus from the brain, the stimulus should be given out to the sense organs of the body. That's what we have discussed. But in the case of reflex act, what is happening is before the information is being sent or is reached to the brain, in the middle itself, the spinal cord is trying to get interrupted into that particular pathway, such that the response is being given by the activity of the spinal cord itself. The spinal cord is not trying to let the information to pass to the brain. Why? Because, for example, let us think that the example that we have discussed in our previous class, touching the hot water ball. So as soon as we touch the hot water ball, we are trying to draw the hand. For example, let us take another example, like we are trying to go near the flame of a candle. The candle is being lit, and for that particular candle, we are trying to put the hand near that particular candle. What will happen for us? Immediately we will try to take the hand back. So for that particular action to be done, for example, let us think that the normal pathway has to be connected inside the body. What will happen? The stimulus have to travel all along, the stimulus have to reach the brain, that particular stimulus have to be read by the brain, and the brain have to give the response, and then the particular response have to be carried on to the sense organ. For example, finger or the hand that we are touching, the flame. For example, if the normal pathway is being carried on in such sort of activities, what will happen? The organism which is trying to do that particular activity will be having an injury before it is trying to respond, right? So it may take a lot of time for the organism to respond. So because of that, what is happening? There are some particular actions that are being reflexively done. Means to say that the particular stimulus without reaching the brain, the spinal cord is getting involved, and the spinal cord is trying to operate some particular muscles inside the body of the organism. For example, let us try to take that the association or the junction that is formed by the respective nerves and the respective muscle cells is termed as the reflex arc. Once again, reflex arc is nothing but the junction which is being formed by the association of the respective nerves and the muscle cells. So those particular reflex arcs are numerously present at the spinal cord. So what exactly happens in the spinal cord? Let us try to see exactly what is the particular activity or the phenomenon that is occurring behind that particular reflex action. So now we are clear that reflex arcs are taking the responsibility to show the response by the organism. Reflex R is nothing but the junction that is formed by the nerves and the respective muscle cells is termed as the reflex arc, and those particular reflex arcs are present at the spinal cord. So till now, if is everyone clear? So let us try to see in detail what exactly we mean by the reflex arc. So please try to note down the figure that has been drawn on the board sheet after I just go on with the explanation. For example, here we are clearly, for example, this is the spinal cord. Okay, the spinal cord is having two particular terminals for it, such that from one terminal there is one particular neuron which is trying to sense the stimulus. So the nerve cells which are trying to get the stimulus are termed as the afferent nerves, as what we have told in the previous session. The nerves which are meant for sensing the information can be called as the afferent nerves or the sensory nerves. So now actually the sensory nerve has the information of that particular stimulus, and that particular stimulus is carried on to the spinal cord. You may now get a doubt, sir. You have drawn a single neuron cell or a single nerve cell. Will a nerve cell will be that long? Yes, sir, definitely. The longest cell inside the body of the human is the nerve cell, which is having the maximum length of 1 meter. Okay, so now actually that particular sensory neuron is trying to sense the particular stimulus, and that sense information will be given to the spinal cord. So now here we are having another neuron which is termed as the relay neuron. What is the function of relay neuron? Relay neuron will receive the information from the sensory neuron, and that particular relay neuron will try to activate the particular muscle cell which is responsible to conduct that particular stimulus. Okay, so here we are dealing with the sensory nerve, and sensory nerve is giving the information to the relay neuron, and from the relay neuron the information or the response is being given out by the motor neuron, which is associated with the muscle of that particular organism. For example, if we think that the person or the organism or the human needs to draw the hand back, means this particular motor neuron will try to get connected to the muscle which is there in the arm of the person in order to help the person to draw the hand back. Okay, so actually there are three particular neurons over here. First one is the sensory neuron, which tries to sense the particular information, and from the sensory neuron the information is being passed on to the next relay neuron, and that relay neuron will try to help in transferring the response through the motor neuron or the efferent neuron or the efferent nerve to the muscle of that particular organism. Okay, so the afferent neuron, the efferent neuron is the one which is responsible to carry the information from the brain to the sense organs. That particular efferent neuron can also be called as the motor neuron or the motor nerve. So here actually we have drawn the two diagrams in today's session. First thing is the structure of neuron, and second thing is the reflex arc. So what I want you people to do is, I want you to do the assignment in two particular sheets. One sheet should be having the diagram of neuron with the neat labeling, and the other sheet should be having the diagram of this particular reflex arc, which will try to carry these particular parts that are mentioned. So children, actually if you are ready or if you are perfect with this particular topic, then we shall try to go on for the next topics in our next sessions. So please try to be clear with these and try to take the time to draw this diagram, and please try to submit the assignments. So children, actually now the time is being given for you to draw the diagram of this particular reflex arc, and as I have told you, you have to do the two assignments, One is the diagram or the structure of the Merrill cell. Second one is the structure of the reflex act. So please avail the time, children. Actually, please draw a neat label diagram of each thing in two separate sheets. Okay. Thank you, children. All the best.